Dr. P. M. Patil, working as professor in ENTC, department of BSCOER Nare campus. So today we will be performing a practical on single phase AC voltage controller. So this is the circuit diagram of it. Here AC supply is connected to a bridge rectifier, which is uncontrolled one. So uncontrolled bridge rectifier, and output of this you can observe it across this load resistance. Here we have connected a Zener diode so that you can clip this voltage to a particular level, followed by a UJT relaxation oscillator over here. This capacitor will be charged through this variable resistance R, and in series with a resistance, fixed resistance R1. By varying this potentiometer, you can change the voltage on this capacitor. Whenever the voltage on this capacitor will reach to eta VBB plus VD, which is connected to emitter of this UJT, whenever it will reach to its value eta VBB plus VD, this UJT will turn on, and here you will get, here we have connected a pulse transformer. Across this pulse transformer you will find a trigger pulse. These trigger pulse, we have used a pulse transformer of the rating 1:1:1, that is, it is having one primary and two secondaries are there. So the same voltage waveform will be available across this secondary as well as this secondary. Now these two secondaries we have connected to the gate and cathode of two SCRs, which are connected back to back. So this is back to back connection of SCRs. Here we have connected AC input to this, and here we are connecting the load. So whenever these pulses will appear during positive half cycle, it will trigger SCR1, and during negative half cycle it will trigger SCR2, so that in load or across load you will find during positive half cycle this SCR1 will conduct and current will flow in one direction. In load it is from top to bottom, and in second case during negative half cycle, as phase neutral will be becoming negative with respect to phase, current will flow by this through load in this direction through SCR and back to this. So in low, across load, current is reversing its direction. During one cycle it is coming from top to bottom, and in another cycle it is going from bottom to top. So alternating voltage will be developed across the load. Now let us observe the waveforms. Now we have connected this power scope across the capacitor, so voltage across capacitor will be observed on power scope. So this is the waveform of charging and discharging, charging and discharging. So during this discharging period, this UJT will turn on, providing the pulses across this pulse transformer. So let us observe these pulses let us observe it directly across load. So this is the load voltage waveform. You can see here both the half cycles are coming. You can observe positive as well as negative half cycle is there, positive half cycle and negative half cycle, but they are controlled one. During this period we have not applied firing pulse, and at this particular instant we have applied firing pulse to SCR1, and as it is positive half cycle, it will be continued across load. At pi plus alpha we have applied firing pulse to SCR2, so it is negative half cycle of supply. So the same supply voltage waveform will be appearing across load. So during alpha to pi and pi plus alpha to 2 pi, these are the waveforms observed across load. By varying this potentiometer, I can change the firing angle. Now I am increasing the firing angle. So firing angle is increased. Firing angle is increased. It will reach to its maximum value, at which the output voltage will be minimum. Now I am reducing the value of alpha, so towards alpha minimum. So this is exactly at 90 degree. You will be observing
exact half cycle, quarter cycle during positive half cycle and quarter cycle during negative half cycle. Further, I am reducing alpha, and this is the value of alpha mean. This alpha mean and alpha max, these values are depending on the value of resistance R1, which is connected in series with R, variable resistance R, and these two are connected to the charging. These will change the charging time constant of this capacitor. So thus, the variable AC voltage will be available across load. So these types of circuits you can use for fan speed regulator or lamp dimmer circuits, light intensity control. So all these, this circuit you can use for variable intensity or variable power, which is AC at the output.